Hi, I'm Dave Burkhart, Marketing Coordinator for Tiger Corporation. Today I'm going to go over the boom joystick control calibration. The video you're about to see is a supplement to the Tiger operator and training manual that comes with every Tiger boom mower. It is important that you read, understand, and follow these instructions in the manual. The instructions I go over today are important to the safe operation of your Tiger boom mower. All joysticks that are sent out loose from Tiger do not come preset. Therefore, you will need to follow these instructions completely to be able to calibrate and set your joystick control for your Tiger boom mower. Often, once the mower hydraulic oil has been brought up to full operating temperature, the joystick may respond differently. The electronic control valve is connected to the Tiger joystick control. This is equipped with high-resolution actuators on main boom, secondary boom, deck roll, and swivel functions. The joystick control is equipped with signal adaption potentiometers located on the back side of the joystick, shown here. These provide signals to the electronic control valve, which send controlled amounts of oil to the boom cylinders. An example would be to raise or lower the main boom. The signal potentiometers need to be adjusted with a small Phillips screwdriver. Remember, these screws are very delicate. Special care must be taken not to damage them. Turning the A or B port potentiometers clockwise increases the boom function speed, and turning them counterclockwise decreases the boom function speed. Before making any adjustments, I like to put on a little tape next to the potentiometers so I can label each to match the diagram. This makes it easier so I know which one I am increasing or decreasing. This diagram is also located in the operator manual for easy reference. First step, set the dead band compensation potentiometer at 50% or halfway between full clockwise and full counterclockwise. The dead band potentiometer is located in the fifth and lowest hole right side on the back of the joystick. Next, set signal for all other adaption potentiometers at 40%, just under halfway between full clockwise and full counterclockwise. Settings should be turned a little left of center, more counterclockwise. This gives us a good starting point. Final adjustments will be made after testing the speed of the boom cylinder. Next, set signal inversion switches. This is the rectangular box located bottom right-hand corner. Number one switch and number four switch are positioned to the right. Number two and number three are positioned to the left. If needed, refer to the diagram in operator's manual. Prior to setting the speed of the potentiometers, it is very important to have the hydraulic oil up to full operating temperature. Best scenario for this would to be operate the tractor and mower at 2200 RPM for approximately 15 minutes first to ensure all oil is warm. Last step is to refine the adjustments of all signal adaption potentiometers for both A and B ports, so all proportional functions achieve the function times we are going to go over here today. If you are not in the times required, turn calibration potentiometers either left or right to increase or decrease speed. First potentiometer that you're going to calibrate is the main boom A port. Extend secondary boom completely, roll the deck so it's level with the ground, and lower main boom until the deck is on the ground. Now index main boom up, function, and determine the time required for main boom to rise completely. This time should be 8 to 10 seconds. Next, we are going to do the B port. Now that you are in the full upright position, index the main boom down function to determine the amount of time required for the deck to contact the ground. This total time should be 6 to 8 seconds. If not, change your potentiometers. Next, you're going to calibrate the secondary boom. Position main boom full up, roll deck out until deck cylinder is fully retracted, and bring secondary boom in completely. Then index the secondary boom out function and determine the time required for the boom to extend out completely. This time should be 8 to 10 seconds. Next, we are going to calibrate the B port. Now that you're in a full out position, index the secondary boom in function and determine the time required for the boom to come all the way in. On this, we should have 8 to 10 seconds. Third, we are going to set and calibrate the potentiometers on the deck roll port A, raise boom to vertical, extend secondary boom out slightly so the deck can be articulated without contacting the main boom, roll the deck in until deck cylinder is completely extended with head curled under secondary boom. Then index the deck rollout function and determine the time required for the deck to roll out. Time on this is 7 to 9 seconds. Next would be the deck roll B port. Once you are in extended out position, reverse direction and index the deck roll in function, determine the required time for the deck to roll in. On this, it should be 7 to 9 seconds. Last calibration will be the boom swivel, port A. Extend booms completely, rotate head to be level with the ground, and make sure you're at a height to have the head and secondary boom clear rear tractor fender when swiveling to stow position. And swivel boom full forward. Then index the boom swivel aft function and determine the time required for the boom to swivel full aft. Use caution when doing this, stop boom before main boom contacts tractor. On this, you should have a 14 to 16 second time frame. Lastly, we will be doing the boom swivel B port. Once you are in the aft position, index the boom swivel forward function and determine the time required for the boom to swivel full forward. Time on this should be 14 to 16 seconds. Again, if you are not matching that time, change your potentiometer either left or right, clockwise or counterclockwise, to match that time frame. All the instructions that we've gone over in this video are also listed in our operator manual that you receive with your Tiger boom mower. If you have specific questions, refer to the operator manual or call our 1-800 number, which will be listed at the end of this video. Again, this has been Dave Burkhart with Tiger Mowers. Thanks for watching.